Soy Luis Fernández, responsable de la planta
Luis
de Trenasa. Es
here
una
on
filial del grupo
behalf
CAF.
Of Trenasa, subsidiary
Hacemos básicamente lo mismo,
group, we do
pero muy pequeñito.
Basically
Somos
the
como
same
100
thing
veces más pequeños.
Group CAF,
pero bueno, también fabricamos trenes
much
y todo el tema de
we also manufacture trains,
auxiliares
and ancillary industry components
para el
for
ferroviario.
The railway industry.
Cuando un departamento de CAF, el departamento de desarrollo corporativo,
when the corporate development department, which is a department that also develops new businesses, called me because they'd heard about this program and they tried to get across to me how I could benefit from this program. We saw the list of companies. We had a whole series of problems and challenges and needs. And we'd never worked in the field of virtual reality. We saw that
BRTech
was on the list. They showed us some demos of what they do. We fell in love with what we could get across, especially when you talk about training, which is something that we were really very concerned about, especially at these times and from now onwards when we at a time of an increased workload, so we need to employ more people, we need to train more people, and they very quickly need to be on our production lines.
Dentro de todas las posibilidades que ofrecía la realidad virtual, vimos una.
Amongst all the possibilities of things you can do with virtual reality, we had to choose one because the program didn't give us time for more than one, and also the project was only going to be running for a few months. So the CAF group, I think you know, you've probably heard about it. We make trains. These trains then have to be tested before you deliver them. And to test them, we put them in these special buildings.
They're
test benches with restricted access because there's a high voltage, there's a certain amount of risk there. It's controlled risk, but it's risk. So there we saw this tremendous opportunity, especially for people that needed to be trained, so they could see before they got into the factory setting, they could spend some time in this kind of a warehouse and see the different security systems, the protocol that needs to be activated every time you want to assemble something or do something. That was the first thing. And then we saw that in this test bench or test shed, all kinds of different suppliers come to visit it from around the world. We've got those that install the air conditioning, the doors, the traction equipment, the brakes. These are people that just come running in one day that have to update the software. They do some trials on the train and then they leave. And so prevention is a very important issue. So what could we do? Well, we thought we could gain a lot of time because when they come to the factory, it's almost as if they've already been there. So they know what they have to do. And Pedro will now probably explain what this program is about. But actually, it's a program that you can work online from home. And it's all advantages. When they told us, they showed us the trials of what they were doing, we thought we were really inside the actual test bench itself, the test shed.
Pues sí, como ha comentado Luis.
Hello, as Luis
al final,
said.
Bueno, lo que nosotros a la hora de pensar en una solución.
When we think of a solution in the end, we always think about the learning pyramid, and we've seen that traditional methods like reading, listening, or seeing, people only retain them, only 10% of what they read is retained. But if you look in blue, you retain 80% of what you do, and that's one of the mantras of virtual reality. And that's when we come into play.
BRTech
are experts in virtual reality, and the solution that we put there was to virtualize both the
en este caso de Trenasa,
installations in Trenasa, and also the procedure that had to be carried out within the installations. And all of this converged to a platform to train workers. It's a virtual platform. This is just a screen shot of the screen where this happens. It's like the test shed in Castellón, in Trenasa.
¿Qué le aporta a los trabajadores una formación virtual?
Does virtual training give an employee? Well, at the end of the day, an employee can practice as if they were actually in the test shed, at the test bench, as many times as they want to. So they become more familiar with their surroundings and with the work proceedings before actually going to their real job.
¿Qué más tiene? Pues el trabajador va aprendiendo a medida que avanza en la aplicación, va aprendiendo de una forma pues, bastante cómoda y bastante divertida.
Esto
se consigue unos niveles de retención y de asimilación mucho mayores que las prácticas
de interiorizar far more than if they were doing it on paper or if they had it explained to them. Another advantage is that everything is recorded.
De modo que pues, luego la persona encargada puede revisar todo lo que han hecho los trabajadores.
In charge of the program needs to review what employees have done. They can see where they've made the mistakes,
lo han hecho mejor,
or where they've performed best, and they can correct.
That is, it's like a preventive measure
because they can correct those mistakes before you get down to the shop floor. And at the end of the day, you can then reduce risks and increase productivity.
El estado actual del proyecto. Bueno, ahora os voy a poner
video para que veáis. What's the project like now? I'm going to show you a video so you've got an idea of what this is all about. What an employee sees when they're in the simulator.
Cada trabajador se va a loguear.
Each employee has to log in so that they can then see how far they've got. There's an initial menu with all the items of the security procedure that needs to be followed within the test shed.
Hay una parte guiada, te va diciendo,
there's a guided part which tells you the procedure that you have to carry out, and you have to do it just as if you were doing it physically when you're on the job. So here what the computer is saying to you
is
you've got to carry out this very important procedure, and there's a series of steps, and the user is being told all the steps they have to take. And they have to do them as if they were in the factory itself.
Al final es eso, es pues que se vaya acostumbrando, que se vaya
habituando. At the end of the day, what it is to get workers used to the procedure that they're going to have to follow, so that when they're
de verdad, se tenga que enfrentar a él,
really
bueno, ya tenga unas nociones, ya sepa,
doing it,
ya sepa
they've got
un poco, pues, qué es lo que tiene que
more
hacer,
or less an idea of what they should be doing,
al mínimo posible.
And then reduce mistakes as much as possible.
Y bueno, pues al final,
in the end,
pues qué ventajas tiene para nosotros el haber podido trabajar con una empresa en este caso,
pues, for us, the fact that we've been able to work with a company such as CAF. Well, we were able to try and check our solutions, trial them.
Al final, and because
at the end of the day,
bueno,
you've got a like a something to show. But it's only when you trial it with a large company that you can see whether it really works.
I mean,
it also gives us the opportunity of seeing how these large companies work firsthand, because initially, they're very imposing. At the end of the day, you get to know them, you work with them, they're just people. They're not all advantages, by the way. We big companies actually work at different speeds, because we've all started out
lo que nos gustaría
hacer, wanting to do lots of different things. And now we've got in mind what we want to do. And such a startup as this one,
a small startup,
just two people, David and Pedro,
donde, claro,
they came to us.
Now we have to
assign them up as suppliers. They have to meet a series of requirements. So, you know, big companies also have their control mechanisms and bureaucracy that actually slow the experience down, but it was actually useful to complain about that, because it's also made us try to be a little bit more flexible. Instead of us customers saying, you know, what's happening to my applications now? They're chasing me. They're saying, hey, you know, you should have sent me these data, otherwise I can't carry on. You know, that's how they are, these people. And I need to accept that actually sometimes the big guys need to pull our socks up. So recognize that, and we need to improve.
Nosotros al final encantados,
at the end, it was great.
Sí que, por lo que dice, ¿no? Nuestros tiempos de respuesta sí que
our response times are far more quickly.
Decisión,
in the end, a decision
llega a mí, lo discuto con mi compañero y ya
comes
está,
to my desk, I discuss it with my partner, and we take the decision. That's it, there's only
bueno,
two of us.
Saltamos toda la burocracia, ¿no? Que,
we can skip all the bureaucracy.
Que es necesario que tengan, pues, grandes empresas, ¿no?
Which, at the end of the day, big companies need.
Pero bueno, nosotros encantados de poder.
But actually, it's great for us to be able to work with a company such as CAF, and in the end,
demostrador que al final te genera mucha credibilidad, ¿no?
We've been able to demonstrate our project, our product, and that gives you a great deal of credibility within the CAF group, and means that you can work with other companies who say, hey, these people have worked with CAF, maybe they're doing something right. And for us, yeah, also, it's a way of testing new technologies, of seeing what's out there in the market. We're actually really happy with this program. We're going to carry on working with them. That's all we have to say, really, isn't it?
Thanks
for your time.